Hello everyone, Tina Spaulding, Trance Channel here again for our Ascension series video. Today we are doing video number 5. Let's see what Jesus has to say to us today. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. And as you are experiencing these intensifying energies, we want to remind you that we have been telling you for a long time that it's going to get very intense and that it's not going to let up. We want you to understand that this has not been done to scare you. It has not been done to cause you anxiety. It has been done to prepare you for the challenging experiences and observations and stories that you are going to be witness to over this next period of time. Now, you have pressures coming at you from all sides. You have the pandemic lockdowns, you have financial challenges, you have political shenanigans going on, you have a lot of things going on, and it's a challenging time. We've told you this, we've prepared you for this. What we want you to understand is that challenges are about growth. Just as you build muscles when you go to the gym, if you lay in bed all day, you don't build muscles and they atrophy. You can see that not being challenged causes atrophy. And this is what has begun to become a real problem in your urbanized technological society. There is this idea of atrophy, which is spiritual lack of challenge, physiological lack of challenge. Some of you go to the gym to keep yourselves healthy, but many of you are not. You have an obesity crisis. You have a lot of people who are very unhealthy, eating unhealthy foods, being entertained by their computers and televisions all the time, not having a particularly active life. And this has become exacerbated by these seemingly outside rules and applications of systems that are being perpetrated right now. This really is a reflection. The loss of freedom that you are experiencing is a reflection of your voluntary giving up of freedom. That is what you are experiencing right now. So, over time, as you have become more and more domesticated, you have given up stimulating activities, climbing mountains, walking through rushing rivers, haying and carrying big bales of hay and throwing them on a truck. Now, you'll say, this is ancient stuff. We live in cities now. We are an urban technological society. You are, but that does not mean that you do not need to grow. It does not mean that you are not physical beings. It does not mean that you are not essentially spiritual beings who come here to expand their consciousness, to use their physicality to have experiences. So, this reflection of restriction that you are having right now is designed to get your attention. It's designed to get your attention so that you say to yourself, hey, I want freedom. Hey, I want to be able to do things. Hey, I want to be able to go here and go there whenever I want, even though I wasn't doing it before. Yes, it's getting your attention. Hey, I don't want chemicals being put in my body, but you're eating Doritos or you're eating, MSG on your Chinese food that you got from the deli. So we want you to begin to see what is this bringing up in you? What is this emphasizing in you? Health, freedom, movement. Health, freedom, movement. These are fundamentals that you see in children. They're healthy, they're running around, they're joyous, woohoo, they're dancing to their favorite music, they're playing with each other, they are on a tear. That is the energy that is natural in you. That is the energy that comes with you so that you can live a full self-expressive life. So we want all of you to look at how you're living, what you're doing. Do you have any excitement about your life? Are you doing anything that's fun? Are you capitulating to this because, well, it's easier, too much trouble, can't be bothered? That is the reflection. And we want you to understand that these coming months are going to be the challenges that you will not be able to ignore. They are going to be challenging, but you will not be able to ignore it. You are going to have to, first of all, manage your minds, or you will be in great stress, under great stress. So we want you to do the lessons of A Course in Miracles. We want you to train your mind so that you can choose, no, I'm not going to watch that. That's a low frequency newscast that's making me feel bad. I'm not going to do that. To be able to exert that kind of discipline, you must train your mind, because your mind has already been trained into passively watching entertainment. If you don't train your mind, you will just do what you have been trained to do. Do as you're told. Sit in front of the, what our dear one calls the boob tube. There's a reason those boxes are in your house. They are influential. You think of them as entertainment, but they are training devices. You are being trained into passivity and compliance by these devices. You are being trained into fear by these devices. You must have your own mind trained enough to say, enough is enough. That thing is leaving my house. That thing is going off. We are not watching that. Now, there are those of you that will listen to this and say, oh, but my TV, I watch movies on my TV. And well, yes, occasionally I get to the news on there. But we want you to really feel into this as you're going through this tumultuous time. Is what you are consuming making you feel happy or scared? Is what you are consuming making you enthusiastic for life or terrified of life? Is what you are consuming violent, hateful, attacking, detrimental, vindictive? Or is it sweet, kind, creative, loving? We'll tell you, if it's on TV, it's not the latter. That is not the frequency that your televisions hold. However, there is a lot of very, very interesting things happening at the moment, and we understand your curiosity and we understand your need for information. But we will tell you, you will not get the truth from your televisions. This is not their job. They are propaganda machines. We want you to find alternative media and watch it reasonably. That means not all day, that means half an hour here, half an hour there. And the rest of the time, invest in yourself, invest in your health, invest in your fitness, invest in your education, invest in learning a new skill, invest in getting to know your neighbors, invest in researching that thing that you'd like to experience in the future, but you don't know how it's going to happen. If you live in an urban environment and you'd like to live on a farm, watch some videos that farmers have done. Learn what they learn. Get your mind in that frequency. Understand that miracle-mindedness is exactly that. It is knowing that you want to do something, but trusting that it's going to come regardless of your limited thinking. But this limited thinking, this conditioned mind, this training program that you've been through must be reworked. You must do it, or you will not be able to creatively manage what's coming your way. So, for those of you that are still in resistance to starting the lessons of A Course in Miracles, we say this is the time, dear ones. This is the time to challenge yourself to master your mind so that your mind is not mastered by somebody else. That is what's happening right now. When you see the frequency and frustration and confusion that is being whipped up into a frenzy by the television news systems, you would understand from an energetic point of view, if you could see what we could see, that people are being manipulated into hatred, fear, confusion. You do not have to feel this way. Even in the most challenging of times, you can feel calm, loving, generous, at peace, and creative. But to do that, you must master your mind. So we challenge those of you that have said no to the Course in Miracles. We challenge you to say, what if I give it a try? What if I give those lessons a try and see if I begin to get a different experience? We guarantee that if you dedicate between 30 and 60 days to those lessons, you will begin to see such a difference in your experience of your own consciousness that you will do all 365. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again soon. Yeah. Okay, so check out the description box below. There'll be links there to my various access points, the Amazon location to buy books, my publisher's location to buy books, if you'd prefer to do that, the community page, and oh, I'll think of something else. Thank you very much for joining me today, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.